These are my students on the line. I give line the loinamak lere online the ni labiri basi. Labiri basi ngasi Rais ne, Rohit ne, Aduga Shukur ne, Sanarjit ne, Lakshmi ne. Lakshmi si hozik in the late magi mobile da kanung ka kogi audio gi midama siem bagumba mali hozik sang tri adu loinamak tabi rangani hai na khale ko. Ado lockdown manung ni na yum dagi leng dana dum labiri rangani hai na khali. Marks season ramon ne khale aisu marks pujar pune hela tho thamani nga ki wena noida electromagnetic induction. I'm just writing electro magnetic induction noi adum not to bui ai ko induction masi a hoy masi le re aina sai hai kare. This is the phenomenon in which magnetic coil amal area suppose here is a coil. Coil si maru ina. Sumai yek na wai. Ko. Sumai na lay re. Coil am akak. The coil am lay re. I am not connected anything with the coil. Coil si da I can book connect to de. I am just connecting a galvanometer. Galvanometer am akak samay si da. G hai rake ko. Coil si na L hai rake. Hai riba si ki sami ba mawong si da. Noi na khan bada. Electric current chien gadra coil si da chelo itra. Si ki mawong si da electric current chien pham thokpra thoktabra. Thokte ko maram di battery of the samdeya haba samrana battery of the samdabani na mayam ta samdabani na chenpam thokte haba sigi galvanometer ji ji kari gina ha mitam ma di electric current cheli chen de ha ba du sigi indicators na ha do ga jin tor ga khang ko do ni adu sigi stage de da electric current amata chen de there is no electric current flowing through this circuit under this condition. This is a coil with the galvanometer. Galvanometer is a device for detecting whether the electric current flows through the coil or not. Adu, now I'm just approaching a bar magnet. This is a bar magnet. Amani, I'm pointing north pole of the bar magnet towards the coil, and I'm just approaching like this. North pole dagi smaina magnetic lines of force smai thu ibani. Ayama. Khange dana noi ko. Class 12 su to kren noi magnetic lines of force. Asigi magnetic lines of force hai masi bokhone magnetic flux so hai nei ko density of lines of force hai unit area da aduna sigi north pole sina onsa lagas maina dak lo insa lag pas da. When I approach the magnet pointing the north pole towards the coil is the tomata bista da an electric current automatically flows through the coil which is indicated by the deflection of the galvanometer. Galvanometer se masam tom da leng ev ko lenga pusina ta ibadi electric current chen chele hari ne aduna sigi magnet sina lengba matam da masa matom da electric current ama induce tong jare imasi bu kari ko ke hamatam da this is the so called induced current ha. Direction of the induced EMF is always opposite to the change means change of magnetic field or magnetic flux. Magnetic lines of force sense the adu against the is always opposite to the change which causes it. Mabu tholi but change hai badi which sense magnetic flux ki change to adu ki opposite ta induce EMF si lagani aduga induce kare nama masamatom da coils the change karma matam da when there is a change in the number of magnetic lines of force linked with the closed circuit or coil and electric current is induced in the coil. This is known as induced current and the phenomenon is known as the electromagnetic induction. This is the first laws of electromagnetic induction. Second law na hari basina magnetic thuna changsa lapa ma de chathok hiba natra coil si leng baleng da ba moine ge relative motion sina maram orga asage sidai da induced current ama thuk targa di hari ba induce emf na traga current to adu change story badu yamaga na yamgani yamdraga na yamoi hai bagi wafa mama ko maduna second law ni I'm just writing the second law number 2 noi sinjan madum ka suka de ko law number 2 na hari bisna keno hai matam da the magnitude of the induce emf E. I'm just writing small letter E because it is changing directly proportional to the rate of change of the magnetic flux, F-L-U-X, flux, linking with the coil. Magnetic flux, which is linked with the coil. Linking with the coil. And what about the direction? Direction, you know, say, first law, the soil, high grade. And the direction occurs in the opposite to the change of the magnetic flux. The direction, okay, is opposite to the change of flux, right? Adudi mathematically, how can I write? Kama ini adudi. Mathematically, it okay. Hai dargadi. Sigi language si. Now you can easily write out in the form of mathematics. The magnitude of the induced EMF. This is induced EMF E. Okay. This is induced EMF. And I write this as the magnitude. Induced EMF magnitude proportional directly to what is proportional directly to the rate of change of the magnetic flux. D means change. D is the small change. Dt is the small time. This is pi m, pi with the suffix m. This is the magnetic flux. So magnitude of the induced EMF proportional directly to the rate of change of magnetic flux. If I write without the magnitude also, you can write this as, I just prefix here negative. Kari gino ayin negative thambasa. Because the direction is opposite to the change. Change ke opposite the direction ogini hydra. Aduna si negative, I just put here negative, one negative sign. Then this is d phi by, what is that? Dt. D phi by dt is the rate of change of magnetic flux. Lo shalak pashti da ayin noida haining basi. Kari no hai matam the electromagnetic induction high basi. It is the phenomenon in which an electric current is induced in a coil because of the relative motion between the coil and a magnet. Or in another word, if there is a change in the number of magnetic lines of force which is linking with the coil, then naturally an induced current is produced in the coil, which is indicated by the deflection in the galvanometer, as I have already told you. And the phenomenon is known as the electromagnetic induction, and the electric current so produced is known as the induced current, and it will be denoted by the symbol small letter I, induced current, not the big letter I, but the small letter I. And the electromotive force, the EMF, the electromotive force or the energy which causes this induced current is known as the induced EMF. And this is also denoted by the symbol small letter E. I'm just using here in the equation small letter E. Small letter I for the induced current, small letter E for the induced EMF. So what Faraday told us about the electromagnetic induction is that whenever you have a change, a relative change or motion between the magnetic flux which is linking with the coil, then you will see an induced current in the coil. Phenomenon is known as the electromagnetic induction, and the electromotive force is known as the induced EMF. And second law was that Faraday also says that how much EMF is produced, induced in the coil, will be determined by the rate at which the magnetic flux is being changed. How fast you are just approaching the bar magnet towards you, or how far it is just receding away from you, it will depend. The faster you move the magnet towards the coil, the more will be the induced EMF. The slower you move the magnet towards the coil, then lesser will be the induced EMF. And if you don't move the magnet, then there is no induced EMF, and hence no electric current, induced current in the coil. And that is why he says that the magnitude of the induced EMF is directly proportional to the rate of change of magnetic flux which is linking with the coil. Rohit, if you have some doubt, โรฮิตอดีกีดีอัติเตดีสุกุสนาจิตสนาจิตยาเรก็อดูอริกดีฮายุมัสกิซี this is the direct evidence of the second law of electromagnetic induction electromagnetic induction ki second law na hai basi the magnitude of the induced emf is directly proportional to the rate of change of the magnetic flux which is linking with the coil and the direction is opposite hai bani asiga language da ithoropa matam da atai si urunu ka sukai dre ha ko mana hari si keno induced emf is a masi it is proportional to and proportional to and equal to on to khara bani ka sukai de so this is how we write out the statement into the mathematical form e equals minus d phi by dt minus means this induced emf occurs always in the opposite direction to the change of the magnetic flux I think Rohit you have understood okay as I suppose that you have understood all and no doubt with this we'll wind up please stay home stay safe thank you